and a very warm welcome to you all in today's episode of Youth Folio, our weekly magazine series in which we take you on a visual trip across the 8 amazingly beautiful states of the Northeast. We bring you news and views, achievers, opportunities, development stories, enforcement of law and order in the 8 states, including nabbing of militants, miscreants and smugglers, and so on. First comes our current issues section. Watch on.
BSF apprehends 21 Bangladeshi infiltrators and debunks Bangladesh's statement on no infiltration. Indo-Tibetan border police set to recruit more women in the force. Assam Rifles nabs militants of different groups in Manipur. Center releases grants and aid to cover deficit in 7 northeastern states. Large-scale poppy destruction drive undertaken in Manipur. Infiltration from Bangladesh is continuing. Denials by Bangladesh can at best be called their misconceptions. This is proved with regular apprehending of infiltrators in the border areas. Recently, vigilant troops of Border Security Force apprehended 9 Bangladeshi nationals while trying to cross the international border at Nadia District, West Bengal on the 2nd of January, and 12 Bangladeshi nationals trying to cross from South Bengal frontier on the 4th of January. All these Bangladeshi nationals were handed over back to the Bangladesh authorities as goodwill gesture. It must be remembered that only a few days back, on the 25th of December 2020, the Director General of Border Guards Bangladesh, Major General Shafinul Islam, had declared during a joint press meet in Guwahati that Bangladeshis have no reason to illegally come to India.
You need to revisit your this perception that large number of Bangladeshis are illegally crossing into Assam. If you see the GDP growth rate of Bangladesh, then you'll find that we are on a steady uprising trend. And now the GDP is about close to $2,300. So there is no reason really for the Bangladeshis to cross and cross the border, be it for the job or for any other reasons.
Border Security Force Director General Rakesh Asthana had maintained that 3,204 people had been caught while infiltrating into India in 2020.
We keep on apprehending. For example, I'll give you, up to 15th of December 2020, we have apprehended 3,204 illegal persons who are immigrating into country. But most of them, this is a total figure, out of which whose nationalities are established, we hand over them back to Bangladesh. Some, most of them are criminal also, like the smugglers, so the appropriate legal actions are taken. Rohingyas especially, I am not in a position to give you the exact figure, but as a border guarding force, we are conscious about the problem, we are alert on the issue, and we keep on apprehending the illegal entrants in our country through that border.
The apprehending of these Bangladeshis have proved Bangladesh wrong and India right. Notwithstanding the infiltration, smuggling and other regular mischiefs by miscreants from both countries, relations between India and Bangladesh has always been very good and strong. It is due to this bond that India has been celebrating the Independence Day of Bangladesh every year. Moreover, BSF organized a Maitri cycle rally along the Indo-Bangla border, which was flagged off by retired Army Chief General Shankar Roy Chowdhury on the 10th of January to uphold this bonding and join in the birth centenary celebrations of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. The rally started from BOP Panitar and will end on the 17th of March at Mizoram frontier. Indo-Tibetan Border Police or ITBP is planning to increase the number of women personnel in its force. At present, ITBP has just about 2,000 women. These women personnel, however, have proved that they can perform superlatively under any circumstance or challenge.
At present, we have around 2,000 of them, then women. Target given by the government is 15%. So we are slowly increasing that component through the recruitments. The every recruitment is increasing the women component in the force. All kind of functions have become gender neutral. Our female colleagues are not willing to get them categorized as soft and do only official works. They are accepting challenge and they are challenging the male counterparts, and they are being given all tough duties. They are working at the border outposts, they are working in forward areas, they are working in combat tasking. So they are into everything. They are into combat positions in the ANO area also, that is LW area in central India. So basically, their entry and their performances and their devotion to duty, dedication to duty, sincerity has led to a situation where all functions are being converted into gender neutral task.
Desirous male hopefuls too must not lose heart. ITBP is all set to increase its battalions and go for large-scale recruitment drive all over the country, including in the Northeast. At present, the strength of ITBP, which guards the Indo-China border, is around 1 lakh personnel.
We have some proposals for a few battalions, which is pending with the government, and we hope shortly we will get sanctions for those battalions, and we will be able to give the better cover at the border.
Apart from guarding the borders, ITBP also helps mountaineers and trekkers who often get lost in the high mountains. The ITBP personnel themselves get training in mountaineering, skiing, etc. for their high risk and tough jobs.
We have done mountaineering and skiing institute in Auli, that is in Uttarakhand. It is at the height of 10,000 plus. We conduct regular mountaineering courses there, regular skiing courses there, because it is mountain force. Every jawan, every officer is required to be expert and familiar with the mountain travel, trekking, mountaineering. They have to always move around in mountains. They need to know the behavior of the mountains. They need to know how the climatic conditions affect our body and mind, how we have to respond to those conditions. So we have regular training institution there. And now we are establishing second institution in Tehri, at Tehri Lake.
While militancy is almost dead in most parts of the Northeast, with militant groups having realized the futility of armed struggle and lives in the jungle and thus opted to surrender, in Manipur, cadres of different groups who are now reduced to being extortionists are being caught by the alert security forces regularly. In the first few days of 2021 itself, Assam Rifles in Manipur apprehended a cadre of KYKL group from Bishnupur, a ZUFJ cadre from Imphal West, a PLA cadre from Langthabal village in Thaubal district, a KNF cadre from Kangpokpi, and another KYKL cadre from Lalumbung village, Churachandpur. These apart, smugglers with illegal foreign goods worth Rs 4 crore approximately were nabbed from Chandel district, and goods worth Rs 21 lakh were nabbed with their carriers from Tengnopal and Chandel district. From Mizoram, Assam Rifles reported seizure of areca nuts worth approximately Rs. 97 lakh and heroin worth Rs. 81 lakh approximately, both from Champhai. The centre has released Rs. 6,195 crore as grants in aid to 14 states of the country, including 7 states of the Northeast, to cover deficit on post-devolution revenue account in 2020-2021, as recommended by the 15th Finance Commission. The 7 Northeastern states are Assam, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Tripura and Sikkim. The amounts are expected to provide the states with additional resources during the corona crisis. As part of Manipur government's war on drugs, a joint team of Imphal East District Police and Narcotics Affairs of Borders conducted a poppy destruction drive at Changshang village, Kangpokpi District, Manipur recently. These before and after shots will show how illegal poppy cultivation, the source of drugs, was flourishing in this area. The state government's poppy destruction drive, which started on the 20th of November, has destroyed 1,184 acres of poppy by the third week of December.
As a part of war on drugs declared by state government of Manipur, Manipur police along with other departments and agencies have conducted destruction of poppy plantation drives at various districts of Manipur starting from 20 November 2020. So far, Manipur police along with various departments had destroyed 1,315 acres of illicit poppy plantation in various districts of Manipur, namely Ukhrul. In Ukhrul, we have destroyed 910 acres of poppy plantation, Senapati 190, likewise Kangpokpi 120 acres, Chuchanpur 50, Tenopal 30, Imphal East 15. Total 1,315 acres of illicit poppy has been destroyed.
This apart, smuggled illegal drugs and their carriers are regularly nabbed, drugs are destroyed, and yet the menace refuses to die down, largely due to the huge amounts of money involved in this illegal trade. Smugglers obviously have no concern that the drugs that they are trading in are irreparably spoiling the lives of many, mainly the youth. Manipur, because of its proximity to Myanmar, which is part of the Golden Drug Triangle, is a major route of pushing drugs into India. It is also among the top states of the country with the dubious distinction of having the maximum number of drug addicts.
Youth from the Northeast are reaching great heights every day in varied fields. In our next section, we shall bring you up close with the first Bodo commercial pilot who hails from Assam. Watch on.
Flying high in the bright blue skies and being on top of the world is an enviable position. Meet young Tulunga Narzari, who hails from Kokrajhar in Bodoland, Assam. Tulunga is the first Bodo commercial pilot. With 3 years of experience today, Tulunga is a proud first officer with India's national carrier, Air India. He has taken his pilot training from abroad, but yet chose to work in the country.
It took around 1.5 years to complete my training in Philippines. I went to Manila to complete my CPL training with multi-engine. And I came to India and I appeared for the exams, DGC exams, and I got my license within 6 months. After that, I went to Madrid, Spain for my Airbus 320 type rating program. And it took me around 2 months. So you can say at least it took around 2.5 years to complete the total pilot training for me. I'm working with Air India Limited right now. I'm working as a first officer. And it's been 3 years and it's a fantastic company to work with. And I'm so proud to be connected with the national carrier of India.
The pilot training course. The expenditure, making his parents very happy.
It was a huge challenge for us because I belong from a very middle class family, and this is beyond our reach to pursue such kind of expensive training. But my father and my mother, like both of my parents, they encouraged me and they supported me. And my father told me not to worry about anything. He sold his the only flat which we were supposed to live in, and paid the money for my training. And this was a huge task. We tried for different scholarships from our government, from my state, but we couldn't get any. We were not that lucky to get any sponsorship. So it was all my parents, and it was a huge task.
The present COVID times are hard for everyone. Pilots who are on the job like Tulunga would vouch that flying aircraft with masks and gloves on is tough.
During COVID, it's of course a very difficult situation for every one of us, for passengers, for the crew, for the engineers, and for me. As a pilot, we take all necessary precautions. We have to wear PPE equipments all the time whenever we are in the aircraft, and we have to sanitize everything. It becomes very difficult while flying with all the PPE gear and mask, and you have to keep wearing it for more than 4 to 5 hours at least. So it's a very difficult situation for us.
Lastly, we talked to the young man about his expectations from the newly formed Pramod Boro-led Bodoland Territorial Council, which has assumed power in Bodoland Territorial Region, his homeland. Though he has studied in Delhi, Tulunga is well clued to his native homeland and answers without hesitating.
I'm very hopeful that the new government will be able to help and develop the infrastructure in our region, and they can support the unprivileged students who want to pursue a lot in different fields but are not able to do that because of financial situations. So I'm very hopeful that the new government will see such will look after such students for their upliftment.
National award-winning artist and sculptor Madhav Das, who hails from Assam, might have chosen to stay on and work in Delhi, but his heart and mind remains in Assam. In our next segment coming up, we shall acquaint you with his thoughts and works.
National award-winning painter and sculptor Madhav Das from Guwahati, Assam, might have shifted to the national capital New Delhi for studies and better work prospects, but his works draw their inspiration from nature and animals, as he saw in Assam. Most of his works include animals and human beings together, be they in sculpting, like this one made in bronze depicting evolution, deer on the head of man, or paintings of rat and man, cow and man, fish and man, and so on. Madhav Das got his award in 2016 for this sculpting titled An Inconvenient Truth.
The National Academy Award which I got, the work was An Inconvenient Truth. And the work is a deer, but you will see for the front part and the back part, and the stomach part is not there because I have constructed there building armatures to show that nature is vanishing, because that memory is from my childhood only.
Madhav Das came to Delhi in 2011 to do his bachelor's from College of Art. Many awards followed. He says Delhi has been good to him.
in Delhi, it's a good experience for me. I'll learn a lot of things, and even from my college also. Because the technical things I have learned here from College of Art, I pass out from College of Art, Delhi. Even my HOD here was very good enough. He teaches me a lot of things, and even discipline also. How to be in this field and how to behave. So I am very much thankful to him.
Notwithstanding the good tidings in Delhi, the pull and influence of the Northeast is all-encompassing in the life of this painter, whose future plans include opening an art studio in Guwahati and helping upcoming artists.
Lots of my works are depends on Assam environments or even natures only, because I am from Assam and it's a nature beautiful place. It's a nature loving place. So all my works are with natures and human.
Friends, we have to wind up our episode now as we've absolutely run out of our episode time. Before we bid adieu, do check out the names of our contest winners of this week.
For our contest section, we had asked, which Security Forces Director General did we interview in the episode? The answer is Indo-Tibetan Border Police or ITBP Director General Surjit Singh Deswal. The winners are Niharika Goswami from Guwahati, Assam, Sonkolal Haukip from Senapati, Manipur, and Lalram Sanghi from Aizawl, Mizoram.
Congratulations, winners. We will recharge your mobile phones with Rs. 500 each within a week's time. Viewers who wish to win similar recharges from us have to answer a very simple contest question. The question, which will win 3 first correct entries mobile recharges of Rs. 500 each, is, name one of the achievers shown in our episode today. Rush your entries to youth_folio@yahoo.com or SMS or WhatsApp to 98101-29327. Don't forget to tune in to Youth Folio again next Saturday at 7:30 p.m. only on DD Assam. You could also check our earlier episodes on YouTube, and please also subscribe to our Vision channel on YouTube. See you all next Saturday. Until then, goodbye and take very good care of yourselves.